And we are back with Andal Invasion, episode 7. Old Corwin's getting on in his age now. He is 55. And finally, you know, he was, you know, took a while. He had three bastard daughters. The first of them was just come of age at 16. Finally, he got this wife, Jane, you know, old Daffin's daughter. It was a blessed marriage, because he got a son, Joffrey. He's also got another son, Meribald, who unfortunately, because, you know, Corwin's a bit of a bad boy, you know, his best friend Roland died thinking that Meribald was his son. So Meribald is now the Lord of Midlord Point, you know, Corwin's going to make sure he's raised right, and it'll be all good. He'll be like a son. He needs to never know the truth, but... Ah, Corwin's getting old now, you know. He's saddle sore, he's tired, he's carved out a kingdom, and now he's got to rule over all these raucous and muttering, angry first men. You know what I mean? There's a lot more first men than Anduls. So now he's got to settle into his kingdom. I think, you know, keep it safe, maybe. Throw a few slave raids here and there. Make the coffers nice and fat, but very little expansion for the rest of Corwin's reign. There will be feasting, lots of feasting. Yeah, let's try to get rid of Lord Robin so we can take Heart's End for ourselves. Ooh, the vassals have had enough of that, I guess. Well. What can you do? Done it to every other one. We'll still get rid of him. Maybe we can kill him at the feast. Feast is deciding what to spend. Let us spend standard amount this time. We need a cast around for who we can raid. Definitely cannot raid the... Well, we could raid the Neck, because it's busy at war. In rebellion against the Starks. Yeah, yeah, I don't care about none of you people. Switch back to ruler justice so I decide all justice in the realm again. Thaddeus is a threat. Nah, he's alright, ah, Thaddeus. How's he got so few troops though? Yeah, let's have some musicians, lovely jubbly. Ah, no, fucking loyalists disbanded. Fuck you guys. You're not loyal no more, Madden. Is that how it is? Yeah, I suppose that's fair play. Still no one to replace her, maybe I should just kill her off. The guests have arrived, welcome to my feast. Welcome. Welcome. Yes, all of you come to my feast. Little old Kellis of Peb said my feast was great. Cheers, Kellis. Aren't you a good egg? Yeah, we'll make a good egg out of Kellis, yeah. He wants an honorary title. He's already got one. Already got one, buddy. You know what, let's make you master of the hunt though, let's butt you up even further. This feast is a success, everyone's happy. Ooh. Hey, another daughter. That'll do. Eliana, sweeter. Lysa, Melissa, Jeff. Cyrene, yeah, what a sort of funky name. Malasa, Lysa. Roslyn. Yeah, I've got Roslyn. I fulfilled the ambition to have 5 children. Lovely. Well, that was a bit touch and go in the early days, but he's going to die with enough kids to continue his dynasty at least. It's been informed it says I'm playing Foxhole. I'm not, obviously. Playing Game of Thrones, Crusader Kings. Clickbait, my girlfriend says. It was an accident. Yeah, everyone wants Foxhole, but you're all gonna have to watch Crusader Kings instead. Yeah, my girlfriend's bought a Foxhole. She's put up with watching lots of it recently. Gotta branch out, it's true though. Gotta keep it fresh, play different things. So we got 5 kids, that is absolutely lovely jubbly. You know what? We've got to build up the war chest. He wants to leave his successors lots of money so they can upgrade the country, build it up. So there's been a load of hamlets and shitty little holdfasts. Roslyn's a feeble little thing. Oh no, not Roslyn. Henry, you must save my Roslyn. Please, you fat little physician that I shouldn't trust. Yes, I could extort my subjects, couldn't I? Who could we extort? The money for the war chest isn't going to raise itself. You decided to take matters into your own hands and see that the chest gets filled to the brim with donations from your loyal subjects. Who shall pay? Oh, that's mean. Let's pay the peasants on what I've dubbed Lord's Finger after we took it from House Brightstone. As it's the slightly less shit shit finger out of the 5. And it's mine. Yep, peasants say I can pay a bit. The peasants of Lord's Finger did, as expected, not appreciate the extra tax to be forced on them. The peasants even elected a leader amongst them who started asking questions. Why is tax necessary? We're gonna starve! Oh, Durka Durka, fuck you and old bastards. Perhaps something should be done before they get the pitchforks. Is it, no, it's still First Men culture, it's not the mix, like, these guys are now Vale Men, as it were. Which means they're a fusion of Andal and First Men. Is necessary, you greedy bastards. Come on. But we'll send the venerable old Sir Emon to bully some of the peasants with some knights, keep them on wraps. It seems whatever treatment Hendry did worked wonders. Rosalind's much better. The gods be praised. Let me just pause it a moment. See if I can get my stream to tell me it's actually playing. You know what I mean? Actually playing the right game. Because no, I'm not playing Foxhole. I am playing CK2. No, I'm not playing Foxhole. You bastard, I'm playing CK2, come on. I apologize. Confuse people then. I'm not playing Foxhole, but it thinks I am. And we'll continue anyway. They all love this, don't they? They're bastards. What stopped me being able to murder people and banish them without them having a little say? I expected better than you from you, Emon, you little bastard. Got favours for Emon, have they? Madden and that's a Hendry. Ah, fuck you, Hendry, you prick. Well, I've sent you a little gift. How do you feel now? Bastards. One of your vassals can be discouraged, my lord. Is that true? Is he even doing anything? Nah, let's not piss him off. We want to build a war chest, though, don't we? So, the smart move would be, of course, to raid someone. And the reeds, Jesus Christ. Imagine if the Reeds actually had been in charge this long, thousands of years in the same family. So they're busy fighting against the Starks. They're getting their asses kicked. I can raise. I mean, I could do with letting my troops build up, but fuck it, I need to stay on the offensive. Corwin might be getting old, but he's still like a caged fucking beast. Can't just leave him chilling. He has no alliances. Whereas I still have Colossus come of age now. Doesn't like me much though. I don't trust Robin though. We're gonna have to let's see if we can plot to kidnap him. Alar's down. Madden's down. Not you, Thaddeus? Ah, fuck you, Thaddeus. You're a prick. Can I change my focus? Let us change to... It's got to be something that keeps me alive longer. Ah, they changed it in CK2, didn't they? That makes sense. Now let's just go family focus. He's focusing inwards onto the dynasty now. That's the important thing. Right, yep, it's settled. Let's raid Crow's Baron while they're busy fighting the Starks. Hopefully Kolos joins me, even though he's pissed off and sick of joining me. An intriguing plot, sire. Yeah, damn right it's intriguing. Oh, you're terrible at warfare, son. So if we do a slave raid. Prestige, blah blah blah, let's do it. Unos momentos. Sorry about that, my lighter went walkabouts. Right, so, let's do it. First things first, will my old buddy, Kolos of the Crossing, get involved? How'd you feel about it, mate? How'd you feel? Ah, yeah, that makes sense. I can't call him into arms to a slave raid, because he's not a slaver. Might not go down too well with his liege, like, my lord, I'm sorry. My friend told me to come. That evil Andal bastard. Let's raise my personal levies. Have them in Scorch Grove. Let's also raise the battle levies. I know what, I'll take over the sisters, but until I've got a fleet, it's not doable. Childless and education focus. My daughter, who's been raised by Jane, who is. Yep. Get her a good tutor. Talking of friends. Hey, there he is. King Wheel the Noble. Killed fucking Osgood the Arrogant for me, which was lovely. Osgood came to war with me. He was like, oh, you've got John Brightstone in prison. Give me him back. My wife, she's cousin. Fuck you. That was the guy that used to own Lord's Finger. Or Brightstone, whatever it's called beforehand. So he went to war with me. I beat him, went down to attack Ghoul's Tower, and this lovely fella here, Will, was already attacking it with his adventurers. Andals. So that was good. So yeah. I think we'll cultivate friendship with this fella right here. Cause we need friendly Andal kingdoms. There was a couple we bullied in the early days, and there's Daffin down there who's technically Corwin's father-in-law. Nice and loyal. Took Will long enough, that's where he's been trying to conquer Ghoul's Town for like 4 years, 5 years. But to be fair, the Royces were also attacking it. Not for anyone wondering who I'm playing as a House Corbray. But obviously we're in the Andal Invasion bookmark, which is like 2,000 years potentially before Game of Thrones proper. This is when the Andals first invade. It's kind of like, in my head, I imagine it like the Normans invading the Celts in England, you know what I mean? Because the first men aren't quite Saxons, they are literally like Celts, bronze and stone and that kind of shit. And the Andals turn up with horses and a sort of early knight tactics and good iron and steel weaponry. Alright, let's jump in. I cut my young ward Sylvia touch. Oh, you bright stones. I bully this family so hard, like, I didn't even realise, like, John Brightstone, after I tortured him and took his son into slavery and blah 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 and whipped his son, he was like, fuck you, but I'm still your vassal for now. And then when I went to attack Ghoulstown later, like, King Osgood's wife, it was his wife, turned out to be another Brightstone, daughter of John. I didn't even notice. There he is. I took her as a bed warmer, and every time my guy tried to have sex with her, she just tried to stab him till eventually I killed her when she tried to stab me again in bed. But look at this poor bastard. John Brightstone, 61, enslaved, scarred. Oh yeah, eventually Osgood's war that he declared to me was for basically to release slaves he had held captive, which is John and his wife. So I just kind of went, okay, fuck you. Sold John off to the east. He's now living in the Blood Marsh. Yeah, it looks like John's living in a lovely place. He's you can enjoy that. Fucking as far east as you can go. He's gonna end his days over there. But one of his daughters is torturing rats. I'm just gonna pray for a soul, whatever, you know. Ain't my problem. Just a little urchin that runs around my keep. Let's gather the troops of vassal inheritance warning. Interesting, why? Where are you currently? Alright, that's fine. So this kid will inherit it, who is married to one of my daughters, so that's fine. Melissa, yeah. Ah, that's what's gonna do, wasn't it? See if we can marry anyone into my nigger's household here, right here. He's already got some crappy little wife. Makes sense. He's just basically conquered Ghoulstown and gone, right, let me marry your daughter, make it official. Is this my son? That's Brian, I'm not paying for your education. Little Andal child. My old steward's son. Yeah, okay, fine. Make you a priest by the looks of it. You can be a dodgy wheeling priest. I'll take you as a squire. See how you get on, but right, Hendry can do most of the heavy lifting. I don't think you're gonna be all that good, mate. Right, let's get a bit of a move on here, don't we? Raid the shit out of these people while they're still busy fighting the Starks. We'll be laughing. Oh, fuck off. Vassal's been levied too long, you pricks. News from the Battle of Winterfell. We have reports that your enemy, Lord Georgian Reed, has been killed whilst leading troops in the battle. Cool. Some bog-dwelling primitives died. Fighting some snow-dwelling primitives, as far as we're concerned. Good for us. More chronic men to cart off into slavery. I feel like I'm just running a medieval protection racket here. It's kind of how kingdoms form up, I guess, technically, in the medieval period, but I'm living it out. First generation just murders people, steals their wives, sells their sons and daughters off into slavery, and then welds the next generation after that into their own culture. Come on, son, hurry up. Where's the music gone? Some of y'all might appreciate a bit of music. Oh! To the letter. Ah, you prick. I knew you'd come out of your mouth. And you do. This is. I don't know what it is with this character. Every time anyone around him's at war, he just goes, right, I'm having it. Ooh, and he's got a lot of troops these days. Interesting. May your humours rot in your body. This is a formal declaration of war. I'm gonna send you back to your little fucking mountain, my friend. Gonna send you crawling back to your mountain. Right, let's pause up briefly. Note down the year that this little prick invaded me from a log. 5th of August, 6506, Robin the Prick invades from the mountains. I've noticed his ambition is to have a dragon. Yeah, good luck, mate. Good luck. Alright, first things first. Call in the allies. Kolos, how do you feel about... Okay, he's... Interesting, that makes sense. He's declared a war on me to try and stop me being a slave or any free of the slaves. Makes sense. So we'll call Kolos in. What about you, Daffin? Oh, Daffin's dead. No one invited me to the funeral, you bastards. Hey, where's my invite? Right, what about you, Tomas, with your gimpy little beard? You wanna be buddies? No. You don't wanna be buddies. How about I bribe you, little prick? Yeah, I thought so. I need a way to get this guy as an ally, but he doesn't have any fucking... No, right, it's just going to be Kolos then. For a battle like this, we're going to have to cart Corwin out. I guess. I'd say so, because... yeah. King Corwin, the practice of slavery is abhorrent and an affront to the rights of man. I hereby demand that slavery be outlawed throughout the kingdom of New Andalos. Failure to comply will result in armed conflict. Suck a dick. No, practicing slavery against your weak tree-worshipping people is my right. Thank you very much. While you're gathering your troops... Yeah, let's send Harris there. Donald's infirm. Sorry, Donald, my old buddy O'Bean. Gotta relieve you as a commander. What we do need to do is see if there's any Andals that are willing to flee here to join me. No? Really? Huh. Kinda surprised. Alright, no worries. Right, let's just march into New Keep. Right, let's march down there. Ah, Kolos, you're a lot, you know, I've got that House Crossfort, or Crossfort Clan. You guys are a lot more loyal and reliable than the Freys who hold your land in about 2,000 years. Much more loyal. Yeah, see, I don't... I think we've kind of got to risk it, haven't we? Madden on one side, Harris on the other. And old Corwin's got to leave his hall. Once more, sit astride a horse. Fuck it. Let's just roll straight into the mountains. Over the mountains of the... Ooh, dear. So we kind of want to pull him back to there. I'm not going to be able to, though. Really? Did not see that guy coming. Shit. Right, let's see if we can pull my mate in. Come on, Kolos. Double time it, bitch. What about you, Tomas? Thank you. All it took was a bag of gold to remind you that we are technically brother-in-laws. And that your father was pretty much my vassal. Come, join me. Men of Strong Song, 4,500 clansmen piling over the mountains. Down the slopes it to me. But as we get a mountain bonus, one has to assume we're finding them in a mountain pass somewhere. What does my army even look like? Ah, a slave raid had to end, that's a shame. so his vassals had like barely any troops with them. They're broken. So he should be able to flank. Robin's in the centre, he's a pussy. Corwin's in the centre. But pretty well matched with everything. He's got more. Okay. Well, thank you, sir. That would be lovely if you'd come join me. You little mustachioed prick. So you can join him before it's too late. Yeah, I have him off here though, because now, as you can see, both these flanks are turned, so we're engaging him all three sides. See, just broke him the second he got engaged from three sides. He broke, even though Corwin's holding him off with much more inferior numbers. Look at that, losses practically none. He's just losing fucking constantly. So you got wiped out. I mean, Corwin's a beast, look at him. It's just the risk of using him in battle at his advanced age. Absolute murderation. Corwin must go home. Madden will lead. What about Emmon? Let's have Emmon lead. Old Emmon on the centre, boy. Siege leader. I was kind of hoping he'd teach people siegecraft, but he never managed to pass it on. Irritatingly. Oh, that's not me dying, is it? Ah, Madden popped as well, man. Damn, obviously the first generation is all dying. All my capable knight retainers are dying, going to be replaced by children. That's two children ruling in the fingers now. What did you die of? Is it just natural death? Only at 54 as well, come on son. And your son is Edam. 11-year-old. Okay. Right, who have we got left then? So that's Edam. Allah's getting pretty old. I can't not say it like that. Allah. I don't know. Thaddeus is in no danger of dying, neither is Kellis. But Alar's going to die pretty soon. And that's it then, out of the old crew. Madden was the last one besides Alar, and obviously Emmon. What we got going on here? I assume that's a river crossing. Yeah. Okay, well, we'll just sit on this side of the river, siege down Moon's Grey. You're welcome to sally out of your capital if you want, bitch. I'm gonna build the veil there one day, I mean the Eyrie. I'm hoping there's an event for that. We need a new master of shippies. I guess we'll wait until we can swim. We'll make it a tradition. The Lord of Paps has to upkeep the fleet we don't have yet. A couple of fishing boats, maybe one or two cogs that head over to Andalos. Ooh, he's bright and he's quick, right? I need to raise him myself, don't I? Maybe pass my own son over to someone else for a little while. Pass him over. I will raise Edam myself for a little while. And then I need to raise my own son fairly soon, though. But I mean, Edam's 11. As long as I raise my son from the main point, should be all good. No, we'll just leave that open for now. No, we can't, can we? Still don't like me, Lothric. Ah, yeah, go away. That plot's not going to work at the moment, is it? Let's just, let us abandon that idea. Yeah, good little lad. Says I'm still raising one of my sons, it's just no one knows it's my son. And they're of old. Where's he gonna go? Heart's Home and Moon's Grave, do they actually have a... Right, fuck it. Let's just crush into this fool. Everyone to stay on me, let's get in there. And Harry's shit, I need someone outside. Who are my commanders these days? Literally just them and Allah. Right, the old King's Justice can get out of there. I really need to get on with the new generation. Otherwise, it's just not going to go well, is it? Everyone's going to die off and it's just going to be incompetent, useless cunts. And nobody wants that. Come on, let's crush him. Who we got? Adam was captured. Just a car of the Hedge Knights. It's pretty funny they didn't change it. Let's just sell you into slavery there, Adam. Going against the will of the council. Ah, screw you guys being honourable trying to stop me doing what I do. You bastards. So you won't let me sell him. Fine, I won't sell him then, I guess. Let's end this war already. This is just costing me money. Yeah, cool. Adopt Thaddeus' ideas on improving the economy. Marius, who the hell are you? Do you want to have a court educator? Don't have a Paramount Knight anymore, do I? It's got to be little Alain, who did pretty well in the jousts in the Grand Tournament. Yeah, you can be the Ting. Do you need more commanders, though? Fresh up and coming bodyguards, no. But yeah, where's a court tutor? Am I being blind? Where's Jane the court tutor? I'm not paying for some random kid. good lad mare of old, a little secret child.
What? Why didn't... What?
Oh, I see, because you're administering to the realm. Gotcha. Let's just hit him in combat one more time, see if we can capture him, because that'd be lovely. Eastwold. And someone's just done some sort of faction shenanigans. Oh, he just pulled Kellis into the Liege Loyalists. Perfect. Kellis has to attend old Corwin as a bodyguard whenever he's called to it, even though he's a lord. Right, what's Eastwell doing? Ah, there's another adventurer. Harsley Laurel's son. Interesting, could have an Andal neighbour. Might nip this one in the bud, we'll see. July 6507, Harsley Lorison. How many troops do you have, Harsley? 2000. Invading the Eastveld. Well, I think we could get in there. Keep her away from factionalism. She doesn't seem to be into that, so it's all good, baby. Catch this little prick, and we'll end this war and have a look at the political situation. Tax revenue. Zay it. Bless how little money our land makes. 15 gold, sire. And I had a feeling we'd capture Robin. Lovely jubbly. Now we could just end the war like that, but it'd be much more fun to sell him back and then do it again. I feel like Corwin's the kind of guy that'd just kill him and execute him, but he's also greedy. Money is good. So we'll take a nice leisurely march to Strong Song. We'll see how much I can sell old Robin for. Ah, oh, Robin, have you not got any gold, my friend? Let's put you in house arrest, buddy. Septon Harris. Oh, I raised you up, Harris. You know, when I came in here, you were a shaggy-haired, wild-beard, crazy man that worshipped trees. I thought I could hear the gods whispering in the trees. And, you know, I'd burned a lot of god's wood before now. But, you know, I was getting old and I was getting nice, and I thought, you know, I gave you a pile of gold. I told you, look, we're going to build a big sept here, you know, amidst, you know, it's going to be a nice, you know, seven-pointed star, and you're going to shave your beard a bit, put on a nice septon's robe, have a shiny crystal, you can be my main septon. You get to, you know, it was going to be good. It was going to be good. And then you do this to me. Old Septon Harris, the convert. Traitor. What should we do with you, Harris? What do you reckon, chat? What should we do with Harris? Bear in mind, Corwin's, I'm role playing by his stats. Stats tell the whole story, really. So you tell me, chap. I'll give you a minute while I skin a cigarette to decide. Fair enough. In that case, I will deal with him myself. Now, of course, I can't imprison him because he's on the fucking council. Hendry, however... Where is Hendry? She's going because she... Yep. You, Hendry, are a bit of a thorn in my side, you know that? This first man has too much power in my council, I don't like it. Sneaky, sneaky first man, winding his way in there. This maester's chain, I don't trust him. I don't trust this citadel. This mythical far south. Where first men are apparently a bit more, you know. Civilized. It's probably all a myth. It ain't really down there. Ooh, what is that? That's a rather large host. Oh my days. Damn. Journey thought over, damn. See, as Andalus falls, more and more Andals are flooding over here. What have you Valerians done with your scouring of Lorath? You had... and to refrain, the question was, what shall I do with that Septon? He's plotting to kill me. You know, he's my main Septon. He's the first man that was the original priest of Coldstream. And I raised him up, converted him to the faith of the Seven. And now he wants to kill me. So, you know, what do I do? Do I just tell him to stop his plot? Do I throw him down a well and burn him alive? You know what I mean? Do I exile him? So many possibilities. Curious to see what this guy's going to do with his big old army, if he's going to take over the Riverlands. We shall see. Anyway, as much as I, how much money will I get out of doing this? They pay me 96. It's gonna take forever to get the amount of money I need for a ransom, so sod it. Pays me 96, that gets me back to where I was. Let's head back home. No, I'm not gonna go into hiding. What we are going to do is make sure everyone that's backing his plot stops it. I know what you're doing, bitches. I know you'd be involved. I enslaved her years ago. She got back into the court somehow. Alright, I need enough favours on my council that I can imprison him. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I need to put two of you. Oh, this Hendry, he's the linchpin here. Well, he will not do me a favour because he's a prick, basically. Yeah, he won't do me a favour, all these dudes. When I owes him favours, he doesn't want to do that. Yeah. Ah! Seems to have flipped. Ah, the favour must have ended. Oh no, it's not. Hendry is just for whatever reason. So he's backing Hendry because he's losing that favour. Hendry's flipped a loyalist. Okay, I take it all back, Hendry. I was just thinking how you're a dirty first man snake that's going to have to be executed, but. Ah, you're on side. Sweet. Harris has no idea that he's actually agreeing to his own execution. Boom. Men sent to Coldwater Burn to arrest Septon Harris were unable to get past his guards. Come on, guys. Harris saw the futility in resisting, however, and has surrendered himself. Of course you did. You have 6 men to call, but we couldn't get past his 6 men. Really? Excellent. Excellente. Alright, we can disband the army. Cool. There's first men invading everywhere. Sorry, I'll refrain, sorry. There are Andals invading everywhere. My son, Prince Joffrey, is doing good stuff. Oh, he's getting old now. Right, we need to switch M on to training the children. You're doing that, you're doing that, you're doing that, that's all good. I need a new septon, but you're terrible. Employ a new courtier, we want a septon. Septon Wendell. Fine, Wendell, you'll do. At least you're not a convert, Wendell, I can trust you. You, Harris, strip you. What? Oh, I'll call him to trial first, okay. Call him to trial. Why do people still worship pagan gods? Unos mementos with that. You still worship the pagan O's there. Good sir, would you go and tell these people that worshipping trees is pointless? Septon Harris has demanded a trial before the court, which Lord Allah Drinkwater shall oversee to ensure justice is served. At the start of the trial, he's formally accused of sedition and conspiracy against the realm, a charge brought by King Corwin Corbray. Septon Harris begins to present his defence, but the court did not seem impressed by this first man. He cuts a very unconvincing and nervous figure. Aelar will interrogate him. Oh, come on, Aelar. Aelar stuttered, stammered, and incoherently rambled in front of the accused, who rebuked his questions and accusations with ease. Unfortunately, his argument was so boring that many at court appeared to be asleep for fook's sake, but everyone still said guilty, good people. Keep him imprisoned. Old High Admiral standing man down. Hello! Whoever you are, sir, you are a badass. Let's have a look at you. He's an actual Veil man as well, I like it. Skill fighter, knight, trust ingredient, sweet. Send you a little gift, keep you sweet. Let's make you a commander. How many people are we keeping an eye on? How did she sneak back home, the old bitch? I banished her years ago. I don't trust you. But we're not rivals anymore. I'll let you off. Who else are we looking at? Howard Sunglass. Oh, that's the guy that took Scorched Veil originally. You're not even that old yet. Damn. It's hilarious. I kicked him out of there. And then I had to go through four different people to rule after him. They all just died of random things in a row. Grayscale, getting assassinated. Disagreement with a mule. I'm cursed that place, I swear down. Thaddeus, why don't you like me anymore, Thaddeus? Come on, son. I've got to bribe all you fools. What's your problem with me? Eh? Come on, here's a pile of gold, cheer up. You mate, you are just what I'm in prison, but... Stupid first man. What about you, Harris? Can we revoke your title yet? I don't get it. How is that the case? I'm revoking it, fuck off. No, mate, you're going to stay in my custody and you are going to be executed, like a little fucking snake you are. Beheaded, hanged, crushed to death, drawn and quartered, put in the bear pit. Let's do it. 20th of November, 6507. Kind of, it's a shame it's not a lion, it'd be a, you know, parody of saying something. 6507, Septon Harris, thrown into the bear pit. That's it, that lovely sound. Beautiful. Age 44, your subject Harris was mauled to death by a bear. Love it. Which means we want to give old Septon Wendell Septon Coldwater Burn. Excellent, eh? Extort people, but I don't know who. Yeah, let's make the peasants pay me. Peasants of Coldwater did not appreciate it. They're gonna get their pitchforks out. Oh no! Revolt risk 4%. Ooh, okay, revolt risk is kind of high, you know. Everyone's kind of pissy with me. Let's hold a fucking feast. But they all say no. I'm not coming to your feast, mate. You're a bastard. On, you know I do the best stuffed venison and whatever the hell else we're selling you. Fowl. Roasted wild man. I don't know. Your dam seems to be very interested in the garments some of the courtiers are wearing. Not in the usual lustful way. He's actually genuinely interested in the fabrics. Oh, isn't he a fashionable young lad, eh? No, you're a no! Nah, yeah, well, he's harmless. Just a fashionable little lad. It's going to turn out, isn't it, that my son that I can't admit is my son is going to be well better than the guy that's actually my son. I can already see it happening. Wait, no, sorry, what am I on about? Adam's not my son, sorry. Marivold's my son. He's turning out just fine, really. Let's take on Marivold as a squire. We're going to spend... standard amount. My levies to build up. 6, 5, 10. Okay. Send out the invitations. Fuck you, you're a tyrant. You should have invited my old lover, who's now just my bezzy friend and my high almoner. Yeah, let's invite Ursula. She's a good lass. Everyone likes Ursula. Kind of want to put some money into upgrading the infrastructure, but... Oh, come on, man. We're best friends. You ain't coming no more. You know what? You're going to be dead soon. You should marry a day first, man. But much willy-nilly. Okay. Well, I'm going to send your daughter a gift, so when you die, she's happy with me. They're all getting a bit too high-minded and zealous these days. As they get old and cranky. While I was busy preparing for my feast, a troop of junglers arrived. Yeah, you can come to my feast and do things. To be honest, the more prestige I die with, the more prestige my son will inherit. Oh, Emon's being too fucking irritating. Everyone's getting cranky and old. It's not good, is it? Adam's turning to Aragorn, little prick. I might have to rein him in a bit. The smith will cure him of his sins. Yeah, pride's fine, mate. Pride's fine. You can be a prideful little shit, that's fine. How's my son coming along? I kind of want... Ah, you know what I need, do need to do? I need to get Valandra married up. Oh shit, he did it already. Ursula's happy I invited her. Alright, let's just have a little look around. Hastley of Eastweald. Rayla Laras. Are you for real? Okay. How about we plot to kill her? See what we can do with that. Slow it down, there's a couple of political considerations I need to think about. I'm also skinning a nice little smoke while I do it. Alright, I play Foxhole enough fast paced when I'm playing CK2 and streaming it. Well, I just chill, take my time. Talk to your people if you're feeling talkative, talk to myself if not, that's not a problem. Just build a little story up in my head, you know? I'm gonna say right now. There's a lot of pissed off people in my court. I'd love to hire you, mate, but you're an old fucking bastard, sorry. But that doesn't remind me, I do need to look into bringing better, not new people in. He's already at war. Slave raid against him. So that's a nice Andal kingdom. That's good stuff. Ghoulstown is still controlled by this guy. A slave raid on here, but that just seems a bit fucked up. Kolo still controls here. Still defending against that guy, but he's got more men, so that's alright. Adam's still sulking in Strong Song. Kinda wanna declare a slave raid on him in a minute. I might do that. Replenish the old coffer runes. Keep them weak anyway, just raid the mountain clansmen for a while. To the crossing and Lysa. Cool. How did Lysa end up? Nobody likes me no more. An agreement has been reached with Lord Corlos to see Lord Corlos of Crossfort and Lady Lysa Cobray wed, and now the dowry is due. Have a token gift, you prick. No, you know what, fine. Let's not say that I'm a niggardly bastard. Take out a loan. Pay the customary dowry. I'm gonna do a slave raid against Prickface over here. Has he got any new friends? No. Hey, Prickface. No. Could be taking more territory, but you know, Corwin's getting old and a bit more cautious, and he's feeling like his realm's fracturous enough as it is. He's taking a lot of land, he just wants to hold it now. And at this rate, friendly neighbours are going to pop up all around. Right, so we're at war. If we could annex this geezer. Really, we should try and go war with this guy and take over him. Ooh, that's expensive. Let's just raise the personal levies, march him to house home. to go crazy or nothing. What's he gonna levy against me? He can't have much left. I already beat him in that other war, which wasn't very long ago at all. In fact, it was only a year ago, so yeah, he's battered. And we're back, bitches. It's time to take your women and your children. Shouldn't have fucked with me, should you? Should have stayed in your mountains. Last thing we need is a peasant revolt of first men while I'm gone. Emmon, go back to bullying peasants on Lord's Finger. Make sure they get that that tax in, that wool tax, not lamb tax. Maybe they'll life's blood of the fingers one day. We'll send in this new guy, Pierce. Okay, he can hold the flank, Master Pierce. Yeah. Harry's can hold the centre. Damn, the old generation's dropping off fast. You need a wifey, don't you, my friend? You know what, let's... lost me a lot of prestige, but I don't even mind. I mean, I probably shouldn't have done that, but fuck it. I like the idea, I didn't want to just sit there with nothing going on. So let's fuck that off then. Don't need that anymore. So Pierce is now in the inner circle, I should keep him good and loyal. I hope he's a loyalist. He is a loyalist, excellent. As is Wendell. Should be able to keep the council in line now, that's good. Miserable bastard robbing the Hearts home to send some troops in as well. Actually, he can hold his troops there. Along with Minister of Snakewoods. Kellisbro, how do you raise so few troops for me? Right, everyone actually does just need a couple of years to replenish, don't they? In we go, tally-ho! And yeah, I was playing some more Foxhole later, no doubt, no doubt. War's still going as far as I know, 1 hour ago. Clinging on in places like, what's it called? Whitechapel. Battling over the same as fucking 5 square meters of Whitechapel that felt like 2 days straight. I think they pushed the battlers out just to the north. Lost 137, he lost 930. Get wrecked, sunshine. Let's go straight for your capital and capture all your family. Give me them tasty, tasty slaves. There's plenty of fat, creepy men over the sea that'll buy you children. just saying. If it gives me a kingdom, I'll sell them all day long. Ah! In the twilight of Corwin's years comes his greatest threat, the Winter Wolf. Damn, son. I'm a bit worried. I'm going to light my spliff before I look at the numbers. Damn, son. I suppose I'm pissing everyone off being a dirty slaver. To the pitiful King Corwin, may wisdom ever elude you. This is a formal declaration of war. What's that, 8th of October? 6508. The Starks declare war. I suppose I did try and slave raid his rebelling vassal. That probably brought me to his attention. He was like, who? What? Fuck this guy. Your Grace, for too long Simon's oak cart has occupied my rightful seat, and I will stop at nothing to take it from him. I humbly ask that you provide me with coins that I may hire an army to achieve this.
Who the hell are you?
Care less about is the north marching towards me. Hmm. 11k. Let's just, for instance, see what the possibility is. Yeah, nah, I don't think so. Oh, bollocks, but I just fucking paid for that dowry, hadn't I? For fuck's sake. Take a loan from a vassal. Oi, you money-grubbing first man, give me some money. It's a forced vassalation. Ah, gotta be a vassal of the King's Winter. Can't afford to extort anyone. See, maybe I should have kept my daughter in reserve for that now. I look like a fucking idiot, don't I? Marrying her internally for a loss of prestige. Just gonna put a fitted IP wise, new up and coming guy, Veil Man. Ah well. Have we any? Of a trial, so we can get a sham trial, sell this bitch into slavery. Right, I'm gonna have to win this world war really quickly now, aren't I? So I can have some bloody money to fight the Kings of Winter. Shit. Innocent bollocks. Ah, series of unfortunate events. Chest. Fuck, I'm gonna have to extort someone. This is a gamble. This is a gamble. Dexterity, excellent. Ah, come on, guys. Everyone doesn't like me, that's the problem. Fuck's sake. I have to get a tyrant on that. Ugh, that was not worth 15 gold. Bollocks. I'm getting sloppy, but whatever. My man's old, he's getting sloppy and real. That's how it goes. What are you plotting, Sylvia? Yeah, you want to kill me. Every Brightstone wants to kill me. I know, I know. Desperate times, friends. Let's hope the Starks get dragged into another war. Don't fancy fighting 11k. Have been raised too long. Such a bright little child. You, sir, are a beast. I don't trust you. I will bring you in as a commander. How's the kids doing? How many men have you got here? Oh, right, of course. Oh no, Rosalind's ill again. He's just doing his job. Fuck, here come the Starks. I'm gonna have to pull Corwin out of his retirement. Oh, he's a Prince of Redmarch, interesting. Guess he's got to try prove himself to his fellow clansmen in the deep south by fighting with his pagan heathens up here. That's all good for me. Which flank has the most light infantry, that one? That's Harwin and Pierce on this side. Alright, let's see if we can get there before. See, the Starks have sent 5,000 men in the first army. We might be able to beat this. Coastlands. Oh, I see. Yeah. Not getting it. Ah, the neck. Nah, not marrying those fools. Lord of North Andalos. Interesting. I should have married her to him, bugger. Let's break that betrothal. Let's marry her to the Lord of North Andalos. Useful if he's got any bloody ships. See if we can pull him in. Luke the champion. Is that because he's held off the Rhoynar? Good. I suppose we need some connections back home. Need some friends after all. Alright, Luke, my friend. Let us see how you feel about an alliance. Ah, he's landlocked though, isn't he? He's not going to have any ships. Never mind. I'll bring prestige. Laius is fine, she's Lady of the Crossing. Belandra are sort of wasted, but never mind, it felt right RP wise. Who can we get Joffrey in with? Where's Ashmark? Too far away. You've not got nothing for me yet. Most irritating. Neither of you have, huh? Well, that didn't last long, did it? Why would I want to shut the gates? Is there a disease? Fancy my odds against the army, I'm really not. I need some kind of friend. I need another friend, quite. There's gotta be someone nearby that I can do. Blackhaven, where's that? No. No good. You're too busy. Oh no, you won. Nicely. We're going to get there before he does. I was asking you about a marriage there, mate. Did you just kind of forget about that? What? Why are you hunchback, son? Oh, I'm confused. Did you just change his mind because he decided to invade me or some shit? Fuck. Alright, well. Whatever will be, will be. Ah, okay, there we go. There we go. Excellent. I don't have the gold to convince him right now. That's problematic. What's his name? Andahar. Okay, okay. No dice. I'd love to give you lost baby girl, but I just can't afford it. Just can't afford it. So you're gonna have to be a child that has very little training. I'm sorry. To a head, see what happens. Stubborn child. Excellent, he's coming at me. Plot to kill Manessa. Excellent, my wife. I know I've kept you around for a reason. Alright, let's see how this plays out. He's coming at me, which is good. Calling Pearson Harwin. Crap fighter, and he's in the army, so hopefully I capture him. That'd be RNGGs at work. But he's coming at me as well, the little prick. King Robin is strong song. Alright, well, this will be the big battle. What are you plotting to do, boy? Place M on his region. I'm not even asked about that. Just don't plot and do that again, okay? Ooh, have we got any? Let's just arrest some of these randoms. Ooh, I might take him on as my, Everyone hates me now. It's like, oh, you're an old tyrant, Corwin. Fuck you. Time's over. Joffrey's still not of age. Innocent, for fuck's sake. Fucking prestige is in the gutter now. It's not good. Murder this guy first. Capture him. Perfect, I think we get the river crossing penalty now. This is the big battle then, people. It's going to make or break the kingdom in the short term. It's the 1st of September. Mountains came to attack us against the rivers, so they could pen us in, to coordinate with these dirty northerners coming from both sides. Good time. Let's do it. Come on, Corwin, you got this. Flanks are getting battered. They're getting broken quite nicely. Corwin's just an absolute beast. If he dies, that his son is not going to be as good. Oh, Jane, what are you planning? Oh, I know that. That's fine. That's fine. I'm in on that plot. That's our plot. Don't worry. Independence. Oh, Kellis. You used to be my boy. I know I'm a bit of a tyrant now, but... Right, Manissa, who is... Oh, she got an heir. Captured Robin, that's the first bit of good luck.
Robin was captured, the northerners were beaten off.
So let's end the slave raid. Ah, province must be occupied first, of course, of course, of course. Well, that's fine, we can just keep Robin in prison for the rest of the war. Keep him in house arrest. While our troops march in. Let's send Corwin back home, because, you know... Harry's in the centre, old Harry's. Let's let that plot roll on and then my son is going to get in there. Shit, she does not like me. There she does. You see in this girl, everyone that was once loyal to me had turned against me in his old age or his vassals. Girl. Huh? I said my girl.
I said girl.
I didn't mean like, hey girl, you fetch me wine. I meant like, my girl. Sorry. Here we go. In we go. I will ask Robin knocked out. We'll occupy some of his land later and take some slaves, but first we've got to deal with these fucking Northmen. There's a lot more will be on the way, that I can assure you all. And that's not gonna be good. What does it say his force strength is right now? So he's been knocked down to 7k, but it's still a lot. Ah, perfect. The Riverlanders are going to war with him anyway. Perfect. I didn't even need an alliance with him in the end. I'm gonna pretend that that has something to do with it, because now he's at war with him anyway. That couldn't have worked out better, really. King Adain.
That should keep the North occupied. The Seven bless us still. Whoa.
Robin Estrada. Fuck, he escaped from the dungeon. Are you taking the absolute piss? I know I put him in house arrest, but come on. Fucking twat. I just didn't want you to die so I could fucking get you to pay your ransom. Alright, these guys think they're landing where? Newkeep, bring it, mate. Just gotta smash any army that comes at me. Ah, they're trying to reinforce together, are they? That's fine, you do that, Master Nerd. Yeah, I've got all the time in the world for my daughters, even though they hate me. Really need to start raising my son myself. How can you hate me that much when I've raised you, man? Come on. Excellent, my son's now a trained fighter. That's a start. He just got chopped up. pick army of the Riverlands or the river in the hills. An enemy host. Oh, that's cool. Castle is impregnable. We got this. Coming at Wycliffe, are you? Winter is coming. Scarlet keep rushed out in this in the meantime. Good boys, good boys. Let's roll down through here. Let's just start occupying these territories. Yeah, let's let that roll across. Just do its thing. Maribald's getting there as well. My secret son. I had by my best friend's wife because, you know, I'm a bastard. Sometimes a king just has to do bad things like that. You stole my sword shields. No. Kellis. Let's make you a commander, Kellis. Fuck it. Oh my god, Ayla, how many books do you have? See, you remember this guy, babe? Still collecting books, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 books. This guy's like a wizard in this time period. He's got 7 books. Like, everyone go and see the great library. 7 books. And there it is, I'm out of gold. There's no one left to extort, man. I've extorted everyone. I've got any prisoners I can... Harwin wants to kill me, does he? Bring it, you little prick. Ah, he ran away, little twat bag. Mate, I brought you in, I made you a commander, and you're trying to murder me. See, now I've got to keep an eye on that plot manually, because I don't want to just auto end plots, because that'll end the plots I actually am involved in, that'll want to keep going. Plus, it's much more useful usually to monitor your plots yourself and using the leverage on characters, or just as money farming, or a way to get rid of characters. Granted, if you're playing like the Byzantine Emperor and you're going to play on fast speed, you can't do that, you'll just get assassinated or some shit happen. But playing a small kingdom, absolutely. You've got mid-max your spies in your plot. I could really have done with capturing that prick. Old King Starkey's died. Ha! Killed in personal combat by Thomas! Yo! Did that happen in May? Was that in that battle? I didn't even clock that. I guess he was just amongst the troops. That's epic. Fuck you, Stark boy. He came down south, tried to fight the Andals and got raped by a little prick with a mustache that's like 18. Got to reward Thomas for that, really. Well done, Thomas. What was this fool's name? Rickard the Direwolf. Ah, oh, your big name. Let's see what your lore. What were you supposed to do, Rickard? Rickard Stark, known as the Laughing Wolf, or the Dire Wolf in this one, for his good nature, was a king of the North and a member of House Stark. He was the son of King John Stark. He took the neck from the Marsh King and took his daughter as wife. Well, he seemed to do that, but then he got murdered by an Andal. It's a hard life, mate. Alright, let's just keep sieging this shit down. We need some slaves, we need some money, and we need them now. Luckily that guy's gone to war, so he's gonna keep him distracted. My liege, I accept your demand, I won't try and murder you, thank you. How you feeling there? You got big balls now. Come on, let's just siege this shit down. I need the monies. Oh, some money's come in, that's good. Edam. Looks just like his dad. Jowly fat bastard. Look at this guy. Ginger, big jowly, chubby ginger man. Oh, it's me, Edam. Edam Cheese. Fashionable lad, he's quick, he's actually pretty damn good, I've got to admit. I need to keep him on side. Alright, slow it all down for a minute now, I've been speeding ahead. That shit's about to fall. Ah, they came out and attacked us, the fuckers. That's that done. The North ain't going to attack for a while, let's just carpet these fools. Oh, he died. She's pretty cool. But I do not trust her. I'll send for a moisture from the Citadel. You all stop back in this plot, please. You're not allowed to kill me. I think if they refuse to back the plot, I mean to stop back in the plot, then I can arrest them. It's not illegal to try and kill me, only to say no and ask you to stop doing it. Yeah, we don't trust Meisters. Let's just send for a co opposition. Oh no, everyone's unhappy. Well, Thaddeus has been a leal and able servant, having successfully. He has been good, Thaddeus, I've got to admit. Yeah. Let's just give him 10 gold. Yeah, that 10 gold should keep you sweet, right? Count the coins and keep the swans. Message tells you of a mercenary band that's just arrived in Whitecliff, along with there was a field surgeon. Aeon, known for his ability to rapidly amputate limbs and save the lives of gravely wounded soldiers. Yeah, let's have this guy looks like. I trust you. Not very, bit of a fighter as well, to be honest. Let's just seize down his capital, see what we get. Your Grace, I'm deeply hesitant to ask, but the coffers of your loyal subjects are running dry from the upkeep of the levies you have raised from our lands. Any recompense for the costs would be great. Yeah, I'd love to help, Kellis. Fuck. Right, yeah, let's Jane doesn't disappoint, she's preggers again. How old is Geoffrey now? Geoffrey. Cruel, okay. He's a skilled fighter and cruel, but that's fine. Let's give him my book. There's a Bible, son. As soon as I came to pick Geoffrey to help me cutting down some trees, he started complaining. Apparently he has a nasty stomach ache. Indolent brat. Ah, don't be a lazy little bastard. Gotta be a king that's proactive like your dad. Hey, Edam Cheese has come of age. Edam, son of Madden.
Well, it's one man of the next generation successfully raised and doesn't hate my guts and is actually pretty damn fucking competent, goddamn. So this fat ginger man's going to be a linchpin of Joffrey's council, I think. Edan, son of Madden, comes of age. And is confirmed in his seat. He will be my Grand Admiral, I believe. So yeah, brilliant commander, excelente. Where's my master of his ships? Master of ships is Pierce, isn't it? I think old Emon, it's time we... Emon, man, you've served faithfully for many a year, but you know, you won that tournament like a badass, and I love you, but you're an old man, come on. It's time to step down, boy. You've amassed a nice little retirement fund, you know. I'll keep you as a bodyguard to honour you, you know what I mean? Like, you still stand behind me and call, look like a badass. You're still a badass, don't worry. So Emon retires in quotation marks at 62. It's kind of embarrassing, sell me job. You're too old, Emon. Too old? I could strike you all down where you stand. Gave my son the 7-pointed star, he can be a nice little zealot. Instead he's too lazy to read by the looks of it. So now we want to switch. I said I was gonna have the Lords of the Paps be the, you know, the admirals, they're gonna see to the navy. As they live on the largest island. Makes sense, right? Makes sense. So that means we need to switch around old Pierce. Reassign you. Pierce, the young Vale man who was married into the family. You know, he's got to be the face of the future. You know what Andal and First Man together look like. So, you know, he's a poster boy for PR. So he's my new master at arms, he's going to train the kiddies. Hey, new lad. We've got quite a bit of potential revolution popping off, but I need the kids trained well. I can handle a bit of revolution. Training the children. The master of ships is open for Edam. Edam is confirmed master of ships, our tiny little navy of one cog and a bunch of fishermen's schoons. What are they called? Schooners? I can't remember the name. It's late at night and I'm on his ship. He should be good and loyal, I believe. Pierce is loyal. Edam is a zealot. Okay, fine, that's cool. Am I gonna knight you? I assume I'm gonna knight you in a minute. Son was born to Pierce, I'm Balandra. So name him after me. Corwin the second. Little mini Corwin. Yeah. Alright, well, it's all going quite well now, actually. This is a brief low point, but the gods are with me. Because the North's getting carpet bombed. That's unfortunate. His armies are coming down to attack me. I smashed the first one, and the rest of them on the retreating first army just get cut up by these guys. Rolling in with a dirty big 20k stack. He's going to be a problem. At least I've got a non-ag with him now. I can ignore
bought everything over the mountains of the moon for a while. Let's speed things up a little bit. Finish taking this settlement already. Come on, come on, come on. I'm no longer humble, that's fine. I try to spend time with my daughter. Yeah, spend time with her. That's all fine. Come on. Your grace arrives to express my... Right, now I need to raise my own son properly. Oh, Corwin, you looking old, boy. That looks a bit too cray-cray. Do it, just some mutton chops, that's all he's got left. Nah. There we go. King Corwin still clinging on at 61. Joffrey might actually make it, he's 11 now. He's kicking off basically. He wants to be a commander. He's like, why the fuck is Sir Mathis a commander? I should be. It's a good point. Mathis can go back to just looking after the Gale. Gale. Jail. I'm trying to say it the old way. The way it's spelled. Well, you make a good point. You make a good point, laddie. How is my. You're still alive, ain't you, mate? Love it. You hate me these days. You were so loyal for years. Now you hate me. I'm sorry. Edam Cheese is absolutely loyal as shit, though. He is... I guess someone else knighted him? I didn't knight him. That's fine. My little lad Meribald, my other son. He's doing all fine. The plot to kill her is still going. Plot to kill me is also still going. I have to set a plot to kill Harwin, aren't I? I don't know, down for that entire rush, whoever the hell he is. My spy mistress needs to be back home, keeping an eye on my ship. I'm sorry, my king, I won't try and kill your royal highness self. Septon Daemon. You Septon Daemon. Ah, everything's happening at once, Jesus Christ. Evil old Obella, Aelar's wife finally died, the old cunt. I exiled 8 years ago and she somehow crawled her way back. She's trying to murder me. Another daughter. I'm not calling her Aglatane. That sounds like some really budget food. Roslyn, Melissa, Lysa, Melandra, Malara. Yeah, Malara, that works. She's got a stutter. Oh, Malara, you can learn humility as you've got a stutter. Oh shit, Melissa's already 14. Yeah, yeah, sure, my friend, sure. Seed some of my family still in the old world. Oh, of course, he wants a dowry, doesn't he? Bollocks. I can't afford a dowry, can I not just tell you to go fuck yourself? Shit. Okay, I'm not depressed anymore, that's good. I'm still stressed. Oh no, I lost stress. Sweet, okay. Back to being broke as a joke. That's alright, that's alright. I wish we'd kept Robin imprisoned. Oh, Pierce. We'll deal with it later. You little shit. Oh, let's just fucking end it. Should net me some slaves. Grace, the group of slaves we captured. and Strong Song were rounded up to join you. Excellent. What we got? We got a young lad called Roran. We've got old Lysa, she's a former slave. We've got a young lad called Duncan and a young lad called Harry. Let's just sell all these fuckers. Come on, the young strapping lads. You can fight them in an arena or something. What about Duncan? Anyone want to buy Duncan? Come on. Master, Lord Xan Li, will you buy Duncan? Nope. Cool, some guy will buy Duncan for 15 gold. That, I'm afraid, is going to have to fucking do, I guess. Just need to get some money generated. What about Harry? Someone buy Harry. Ugh, Harry's apparently fucking useless. I don't know what to breed him with, I can't make any more slaves. No one wants to buy him either, do they? Well, that was a pile of shit, wasn't it? Oh man. Let's put our prestiges back up. Right, we need a march. I don't really want to march, but I know I'm not even going to bother. I'm going to disband my army. Send my allies north. You guys just focus on sieging the enemy out. That should be that. Got no prisoners, but can I get some? So Daemon wants to do some shit, some prisoners of Daemon. I love when Septons just hand themselves over like, yeah, you're right, I probably shouldn't try and fuck with you, should I? Call him to trial, although fucking you got a nervous and unconvincing figure. Oh. Fuck, I need to stop letting A-Lab in. No. You're no good at your job anymore. Bollocks. I can't get anything through the council at this point either, kinda. What can I do? And if I win this war, what will I get? 100 net gold? Well, that would be nice. Strength rebuild. Let's just let things speed up a little bit, play out. Stop this fucking plot to kill me, Jesus Christ. Is that plot to kill me this or ever gonna fire off? Enough with your plotting, scumbags. Who are you? Fuck, I have a non-aggression pact with him. fuck. Right, okay. Eastweald is still ruled.
Iron Handle, that's all well and good. Who are you fighting? I'd like to get involved in any war, but I kinda need to chill.
Face Tomas hadn't killed the king. Ignoble. Came to stop me doing a slave raid, some insignificant little Andor colony. We just changed the fate of Westeros. Okay, Adam the Eagle. Subjugates the north. So I thought I was going to go on till Corwin dies, but he's holding on, the tenacious bastard.
Soon. In fact, yeah, I think I have to do it in a minute because hit the 2 hour mark now. I'd very much like for her to die. That would be lovely. Interesting. You've arranged to meet with Lord Harrimond of Mormont Keep. Who is himself. Oh, no, no, no. A wealthy man from Bear Island who wishes to purchase one of your slaves. He finally makes his choice, slaying one. Interesting. Are they slavers? Ah, because he's under the Iron Isles. Interesting, he's an old Ironborn. He wants to buy him. Okay, interesting. How much gold do you have, mate? Quite a lot of gold. I'm not going to be greedy. I'll take him for 40 gold. Come on. Come on. Hey. Excellent, hey. And we are back in the green. Crazy Court Physician guy is actually a badass commander in a pinch. Oh, we've still got a lot of vassals we need to get rid of. You, Robin. I really do need to plot to fabricate treason against you. Stop trying to murder me! Not about it. Even Pierce is in it. Come on, Pierce, you prick. Yeah, cool. I'll murder him. Yeah. You think your wife can control her little infant brother? Joffrey's gonna be a badass. Just you watch. Ain't you, Joff? Look at you. He's only a skilled fighter at 11. It's gonna be good. My son Joffrey's strong. Right, I think we're going to call it a part there, folks. Keep looking around for a minute, actually. Yeah. Let's see where we're going to go from there. No, yeah, I think we'll call it a part there. Hope you all enjoyed it. We'll probably return with part two probably Friday night. We'll do a part on Friday night, a part on Saturday night. We'll back some Foxhole later on tonight. That's all for now. Cheers for watching.